Students, very good evening to all of you. Today, I am here with you one video on traction system. Now, before discussing what is traction system, what are the advantages of traction system, what are the various types of traction system, first of all, we have to be noted down or must be understand what do you mean by this term traction. Traction means driving a vehicle or driving a locomotive. In simple language, when we can say that driving a vehicle or driving a locomotive, it is called as traction, and the system which employs this mechanism is called as traction system. The traction system are basically classified into two main categories. Number one, non-electric traction system, and number two, electric traction system. Now, what is the main difference between this non-electric traction system and this electric traction system is the involvement of electrical equipment in traction system. For example, if an electrical motor can be used to drive a vehicle or to run a vehicle or to run a locomotive, then this type of system is known as electric traction system. And if the driving of the vehicle is done without the help of electrical motor, then it is called as non-electric traction system. Now, non-electric traction system, as I have already explained to you, in which there is no electrical energy available at any stage. The best example for the non-electric traction system is your steam engine that can be used in Indian Railways, and internal combustion engine that can be used by all the transport in your road transport. For example, the vehicles, the cars that are moving in our road. These are the examples of non-electric traction system. But in case of an electric traction system, as I have already explained to you, in case of electric traction system, the driving force is generated by the means of electricity. And this electricity can be available to the vehicle with the help of electrical motors. Now, these electrical motors are dependent upon their nature of input supply. For example, if the nature of input supply is DC, then this DC will be given to the electrical motor, then this motor is known as DC motor. And in that case, the traction system is known as DC traction system. Whereas, if the nature of the supply is AC and this AC is given to the motor, then this motor is called as your AC motor. And that system is called as your AC traction system. So, dependent upon the nature of the input supply, whether it is an AC, whether it is a DC, we can classify your traction system as AC traction system as well as DC traction system. Broadly, this electric traction system can be divided into two main categories. Number one, where जहां पर हमारे पास व्हीकल में जो इनपुट आती है वो किसी ना किसी मोटर से आती है, और वो जो मोटर है वो मोटर आपकी डीसी बैटरी इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर हो सकती है, वो आपकी डीजल इलेक्ट्रिक ड्राइव मोटर हो सकती है. यू कैन से दैट इन केस ऑफ बैटरी इलेक्ट्रिक ड्राइव द आउटपुट ऑफ द बैटरी इज डीसी, सो दिस डीसी इज गिवन टू द इलेक्ट्रिकल मोटर एज अ इनपुट. The electrical motor will start rotating and motor converts this electrical energy into the mechanical energy, and after that this mechanical energy is given to the wheels of the locomotive, and ultimately the locomotive will start rotate. So this is the example of your battery electric drive system. Whereas in case of diesel electric drive system, what will be happen, we are using a combustion in which diesel is put in a cylinder. Then after that, this fuel energy is converted into the heat energy. After that, this heat energy is converted into the mechanical energy. And we are using a generator here, and the generator will convert this mechanical energy into electrical energy. So the output of the generator is given to the motor, and after that this motor will start rotating, and this motor is directly coupled with the wheels of the drive, wheels of the locomotive, and hence the locomotive will start to rotate. Hence this type of drive system is basically called as your diesel electric drive system. We have another group consists of vehicle which receives electrical power from a distribution network fed at suitable point from either central power station or suitably spaced substation. For example, the railway electric locomotive fed from overhead AC supply, tramways, trolleyways. So these are the examples where we can say that these all uses your electric drive system in one or another way. Now coming to the part, the type of traction system, here you can see that it is basically the whole classification of this traction system. The whole traction system can be classified into two main categories, as I have already explained earlier. One is called as non-electric traction system and another is called as electric traction system. The traction system in which there is no electrical equipment involvement is there, it's called as non-electric system. Whereas the traction system in which there is an involvement of electrical equipment like motor, then it is called as electric traction system, as I have already explained earlier. Now, the non-electric traction system can further classified as steam engine drive and internal combustion engine drive. Whereas this electrical traction system can further divided as diesel electric drive system, battery electric drive system, petrol electric drive system, as well as electric drive system. Now, the main classification between diesel, battery, petrol, and electric vehicle is that in case of a diesel electric drive system, we are using diesel as a fuel in a generator. This generator will generate electrical energy. This electrical energy as an output of the generator is given to the motor, and this motor will start rotating, and after that this output of the motor is given to the wheel of the locomotive, and hence the locomotive will start rotate or develops. In case of battery electric drive system, here the output of the battery is given to the motor, and this motor is connected to the locomotive. Whereas in case of a petrol electric drive, instead of diesel fuel, we are using a petrol fuel. So you can say that diesel electric drive system and petrol electric drive system is one of the same thing, but only the difference is the input of the fuel used. In diesel electric drive system, we are using a diesel fuel, whereas in case of a petrol electric drive system, we are using a petrol as a fuel. But the principle behind the traction system is one of the same thing. But only in case of an electric drive system, what will be happen? The motor taking its input energy direct from the distributed network or from the transmission line. The transmission line is having a voltage up to certain kV level, and this voltage is basically an AC voltage. So the motor installed in a locomotive can take the power from this overhead distribution network, and this power will be given to the electrical motors that are installed in a locomotive, and hence this locomotive start rotate in a particular direction. This electrical drive system can further divided into three main categories. We have electrical rail, we have trolley bus, and we have tramways. These are discussed with one by one. I think this will be clear to all of you. That is about the classification of your traction system. Now coming to the part of diesel electric drive system, the diesel electric drive system, as I have already explained to you, uses a diesel engine to drive the electric generator, which then supplies the current to the traction motor, which are geared directly to the locomotive vehicles. The first electric diesel electric drive system is in 1945 for a short service on a board gauge line, and in 1956 for a mainline operation, it was introduced. In 1958, Indian Railways went in for extensive mainline decision. These are the more suitable for remote areas as well as hilly areas. It provides more torque as compared to the steam engine. So this is all about the diesel electric drive system. Coming to the part, the advantages of a diesel-like system compared to steam locomotive, diesel requires a very less maintenance and it can be started up and shut down a very instantly. Efficiency of the diesel locomotive is very, very high as compared to the steam engine. The overall efficiency is about 45%. There is no interference to the communication line with the help of with the uses of diesel electric locomotive. It can be operate on any route. It will be available for hauling for about 90% of its working days. So these are some advantages of a diesel electric locomotive. Coming to the part, it also contains certain disadvantages, like its initial cost is very, very high. As you know, we are using diesel as a fuel. So this diesel is basically a non-renewable source of energy. So the time will come when this diesel will get depleted. So in that case, this diesel electric drive system can also be depleted. Locomotive require cooling system to control the diesel engine, because as you know, we are using a diesel and the fuel energy is converted into the heat energy. And when heat energy will generate it, it will create a lot of high temperature in the surrounding. So in order to maintain its high efficiency, in order to maintain the locomotive in a better option way, you are requiring a cooling. So in that case, some cooling devices are also required, which ultimately increases the cost. It is heavier than plain electric drive because it carries a diesel engine, the main generator, as well as the traction motor. So with the help of, you can say that with the uses of this diesel engine system, the system becomes very, very bulky, as well as it is not robust in nature. So this is basically the disadvantages of diesel electric drive system. So coming to the next part, that is electric traction system. And in this electric traction system, you have trolley bus, that is number one. It is also known as trolley coach, trackless trolley, trackless tram. It is an electrical bus that draws a power from the overhead transmission line using spring load trolley poles. Two wires and the poles are required to complete the electrical circuit, and it is used in various countries like China, England, and nowadays in India we can also use it in this trolley buses, in, you can say that, gondola drives and all that. This is one of the, you can say that, most important component of electric drive system. Coming to the advantages of this system, compared to steam locomotive, diesel requires a very less maintenance. The advantages, the construction of trolley bus cheaper than trams, because in case of a tram that I will discuss after this, trams requires a track also, but in case of a trolley where there is no track requirement, so it will be become cheaper. Trolley buses are almost silent drive. There is no pollution. There is no, you can say that, radio interference will be there. There is no noise pollution included in them. They are environmentally friendly because it does not use any type of fuel, that is a coal, diesel, petrol, etc. The maintenance and running cost is very, very low because in this we have no requirement of any fuel. So when there is no requirement of fuel, so there is no byproducts of fuel inside the, you can say that, the cylinder or a engine. So the maintenance cost is very, very low is in case of your trolley buses. But although it has certain disadvantages, the number one disadvantage is that trolley bus cannot be used in medium traffic area, yeah, dense traffic area where we have a large number of population exist. This type of trolley buses can be, not be used. Trolley buses are specially used where the electricity is abundant and cheap, because as we know, these trolley buses are totally wholly solely dependent upon electricity. So where we have a lot amount of electricity is available, and moreover the cost of, you can say that, purchasing the electricity is also low, in that case we can use this trolleyways. Overhead equipment requires for the trolley buses are more expensive than trams, because in order to move a trolley from one point to the another point, you are requiring the suspension between the two points, you are requiring the poles, you are requiring the conductor. So in that case, the cost will increase, slightly increase will be high. So these are some disadvantages of a trolley electric drive. We have advantages of electric traction system as compared to the another methods of traction system are, number one, cleanliness. As you all know, in case of electric traction system, there is no fuel is required, only electricity is required. So electricity has become very, very clean as compared to the other fuel required. So you can say that your electric traction system is very, very clean as compared to the another traction system. Maintenance cost is very, very low because it does not involve so much equipment, does not require any fuel. So in that case, your maintenance cost is very, very low as compared to your another traction system. Starting time is very, very high. It will start with a possible shortest time. It will start with a possible shortest time. So you can say that its starting time is very, very low as compared to another traction system. High starting torque. The motor used in traction system is a very high starting torque. Hence, it provides another advantages over the electric traction system. So these are basically some advantages of electric traction system over the another traction system that we can use. Hope you can understand about what do you mean by the traction system, what are the classification of traction system, where we have to deal with the non-electric traction system and the electric traction system. What do you mean by this trolley traction system, the advantages, the disadvantages. Now in the next video, I am coming with your another electric drive system in which we are dealing about tramways, how these are operate, what are the various components required for the tramways, what are its advantages, what are disadvantages. Hope so, you can understand this very well. So thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much.